We rip out so much of ourselves to be cured of things faster that we go bankrupt by the age of 30 and have less to offer each time we start with someone new. But to make yourself feel nothing so as not to feel anything, what a waste.
Feeling. Fear. Sadness. Joy. Love. I was recently confronted with these feelings while watching Luca Guadagnino's rapturously beautiful 2017 romance, Call Me By Your Name, and was reminded of why I love cinema so much. The art of film boils down to telling a story, examining the human condition, and trying your best to understand it. And no director has accomplished this feat better than Luca Guadagnino through his Desire trilogy, which includes I Am Love, A Bigger Splash, and Call Me By Your Name. Specifically, he does this by taking an intensely realistic approach to depicting humanism in his films in order to create movies that are alive with feeling. There are 8 core methods that Guadagnino uses in his films to evoke feeling. The first includes his tendency to have long takes follow characters in order to break the barrier between the viewer and the film. The viewer is no longer just a disconnected spectator. They are part of the experience. Long shots like this create a sense of realness, since there are no distracting cuts to take the viewer out of the moment. In addition to this, there are also several shots throughout his movies that are from the perspective of certain characters, therefore making the audience truly understand and take in what is happening from their point of view. By doing this, characters are humanized and their actions can be more easily comprehended, therefore allowing for a stronger bond to the characters and for a poignant relationship to the emotions that they undergo. An example of this can be found in the dinner table scene from A Bigger Splash, where the camera flows to the points of views of the characters sitting across from the opposing characters, highlighting where each character is at their point in the story. Another defining aspect of his filmmaking is the sound editing and mixing, which takes in everything in the environment so that it feels like a living, breathing place that almost becomes a character of its own. The cinematography and the lush colors are also key to building a world that does not feel artificial, but has a rather dreamy and sublime quality to it, which unarms the viewer and makes them feel more emotionally engaged. Two examples from his films that include those techniques of sound and sight can be displayed through a scene from A Bigger Splash and a scene from Call Me By Your Name. The first scene from A Bigger Splash is a moment of pure fear that takes place during a dreadful fight in a pool. The reason that this scene is so terrifying is because of the uneasiness that builds up over the uncomfortable long shot, and because of the queasy noises of the water splashing and of the men gasping for air, with the quiet sound effect of something sinister lurking. The second scene from Call Me By Your Name is a moment of true heartbreak. The camera just lingers on and forces the viewer to sadly reflect on alongside Elio. This shot is incredibly powerful because of its simplicity and because of the raw emotion that is shown. It doesn't feel calculated. It feels honest to a heartbreaking extent. The fifth thing that I wanted to mention regarding feeling in his films is his use of music. Whether it be more classical pieces or transcendent ballads by Sir John Stevens, music is employed to cathartic scenes, since it is in the nature of music to communicate thoughts and express emotions. The sixth aspect is Guadagnino's storytelling and the pace that his films move at. His films are always at a steady pace and slowly build over time. One of the most fascinating things about Call Me By Your Name is how there's no stereotypical antagonist or opposing force. The only conflict is between the characters and ultimately time. By going at a relaxing pace, Guadagnino's films unguard the viewer and then hit them when they're least prepared for it. Another powerful characteristic to his filmmaking are the characters and actors, who always feel real and as if they have a purpose in each of his films.
You're obscene.
We're all obscene. Everyone's obscene. That's the whole fucking point. We see it and we love each other anyway.
If Armie Hammer and Timothy Chalamet were not good in Call Me By Your Name, then the film would just fall apart. But they are so in sync with the rhythm of the film that they manage to be two of the definitive reasons as for why Call Me By Your Name is one of the most beautiful films of the decade. But in my opinion, the most essential feature to Guadagnino's style is his ability to access the senses. By obtaining full control over the senses, Guadagnino manages to make his films feel like real life. In 1888, the first motion picture film called Round Hay Garden Scene was released and was the first film to utilize the sense of sight. Later on, in 1927, the first talkie film called The Jazz Singer was released and was the first film to utilize the sense of hearing. Since then, filmmakers have seemed to have limited themselves to strictly the two senses of sight and hearing. But Guadagnino realized that film is about exploring and about expressing yourself through art, through whatever means necessary. And so he decided to take the next step forward and utilize those other senses. In his films, you can taste, smell, and you can touch. By utilizing all five of the senses, Guadagnino accesses to the culmination of those five senses, real, genuine feeling. Luca Guadagnino is a cinematic genius, and I recommend that you check out any of his films if you haven't already. Thanks for watching, and I actually have one more thing to say. My favorite quote regarding the art of film is loosely based on a quote that Ingmar Bergman stated regarding Andrei Tarkovsky's films, and I think that it perfectly applies to Guadagnino's films. It is as follows. Film captures the essence of life. Life as a dream. Life as a reflection.
Hello.